Now, this is an incredibly tough question. Even though we've gone over this before, and I've taught you how we compute this, it is pretty difficult, and it takes some time to really grasp what's going on here. So we're going to go through this again. Bear with me, and you'll get it eventually, I promise, if you don't already. We know that 95% of sample means will be within 1.96 standard deviations of the population mean, which is also the mean of sample means. Now let's just zoom in on this part over here. This sample mean doesn't change, it's there. But if it's gonna be one of the 95% of sample means that falls within 1.96 standard deviations from the mean, then the population mean can range from here to here. So this here is the range in which the population mean of everyone who uses the Bieber tweeter is most likely to fall. So you see that this range is 40 plus 1.96 standard deviations and 40 minus 1.96 standard deviations. And we know that since this is the same shape as our sampling distribution, that our standard deviation is the population standard deviation divided by the square root of n. I know I just said a lot of confusing things, so let's write it out. So here we should have 40 minus 1.96 standard deviations, and then 40 plus 1.96 standard deviations. And we know that the standard deviation is our standard error. Okay, so we already know that our standard error is 2.71. So we have 40 minus 1.96 times 2.71. and 40 plus 1.96 times 2.71. So this is about 34.69 to 45.31. So our confidence interval for the population mean is something like this. So if everyone were to use the Bieber tweeter, our point estimate is 40, and our interval estimate is our 95% confidence interval.